acting for him, knowing that he's Abby's father.
Why on earth not? No one else knows, and Charles certainly isn't going to tell anyone.
It'd just be too humiliating.
Oh, come on, Gerald. It was 19 years ago. And you know perfectly well he hasn't been the only one.
He's the only one you've had a child by. Look, Polly, I can turn a blind eye to the others, but not my employer.
So what do you intend to do?
Well, I'll just open a new office somewhere, start a new practice.
And reduce our income to a pittance.
It shouldn't take me long to get myself established.
Conveyancing, drawing up wills, legal aid cases.
Why not? I mean, that's how most solicitors earn a living. I'm also a chartered accountant.
No, Gerald. You hitched your wagon to Charles's star, and it's too late to detach it now. You are going to ask him to take you back.
No.
Then I shall. Hello, Leo.
Mum told you.
Told me what?
Claude and I are engaged.
Oh, that's terrific. I thought something was going on when you started wearing makeup for breakfast. Well, congratulations, kiddo.
You don't congratulate the girl, you congratulate the man on being fortunate enough to win such a prize.
Well, sounds like a raffle. Welcome to the family, Claude.
Thank you, Leo.
Of course, you don't know what you're taking on, do you? I mean, she's told you about her alcohol problem, has she? About the time she got nicked for soliciting.
Yes, but she has promised to keep off booze and men for at least 1 month.
Mum, isn't it about time you said something?
I'm very happy for you, darling. You too, Claude.
Really?
Yes, really. And to show you just how happy I am, I'll see if I can find some champagne.
Take over, huh? Maybe they heard about the catamaran.
Rilton do have other assets, Tom.
Oh, but why now? Catamaran is their only new asset. Oh, talking about new assets, it seems I'm about to acquire one. A son-in-law.
Claude Dupont.
Oh, it's common knowledge, is it?
I saw him and Lynn down at the Yacht Club. They seem to have established their own entente cordiale.
Mm. He came to see me last night. Obviously very much in love.
But?
Oh. Why should it be a but?
Well, you don't seem exactly thrilled about it. What's worrying you?
Oh, Jan called. Apparently Claude's been engaged before and called it off just before the wedding.
So she wants you to talk to him, find out whether his intentions are honourable?
Oh, something like that.
Are you going to?
Well, he's hardly likely to tell me his intentions are dishonourable, is he?
Bill was here earlier this evening. He's threatening to resign.
Because of the bloody beam? Mm. This is ridiculous.
He says his professional reputation's at stake, Tom.
So's mine.
Well, can't you just talk to him, set his mind at rest?
No, Avril. I don't tell him how to do his job. He doesn't tell me how to do mine. This dispute is non-negotiable.
You've dropped the risky. Thank you, Hamilton. That'll be all. Yes. That's what I wanted to do when I suggested it. You didn't want to know.
Mm-hmm. That was then.
Well, what's changed your mind? Oh, come on, Charles. This whole thing stinks to me. I want to know.
I decided I was being rather short-sighted. Now that I'm a member of this community, I can't afford to antagonize local opinion.
You never used to worry about that.
No. But there'll be other projects. Projects for which I shall need a reservoir of goodwill. So I thought it wiser to take the long-term view.
And what's happening to the development site?
I've done a deal with the council. They've agreed to buy it back at cost.
Your cost or mine?
Mine.
So you come out of it with a nice little profit?
Only because you lost your nerve. If you'd hung on, you'd have been able to sell at par.
I couldn't afford to hang on.
Well, that's the luck of the game, isn't it? If you can't stand the heat, stay away from the kitchen, as they say.
Yeah. You kited me, Charles. I don't like that.
If you remember, Ken, I didn't particularly want your shares. I only took them off you as a favour.
As a favour? You made £750,000 out of it.
As I say, the luck of the game.
You know what I think? I don't think you give a damn about antagonizing local opinion. I think there's another reason.
What other reason could there possibly be?
I don't know. Yet. But I intend to find out.
Morning, David. Good of you to see me before the meeting.
I was intrigued.
Something to my advantage, you said?
That's right.
Intrigued and rather suspicious.
Suspicious?
Whenever I'm offered something to my advantage, it usually costs a great deal of money. Can I offer you a cup of coffee?
Black, please. No sugar.
Well?
David, would you be interested in buying a quarter of my holding in the Mermaid Boatyard?
At what price?
Market value.
Which is?
40 grand.
I should have to see the books.
Oh. Naturally.
I'll need 24 hours.
Fine. But, can we keep this between ourselves?
Financial problems, Jack?
No, no, it's just that I've got a good chance of getting in on the ground floor of something big, so I, need a bit of liquidity.
Well, well. Is this what we call a caucus?
Oh, hello, Admiral. Coffee?
If you're sure I'm not interrupting.
Interrupting? No, no, no. I just dropped in to bring myself up to date. I do have an interest in this company, you know.
I know, but I was beginning to wonder if you did. I'm sick of having to page you at every race course in the country.
I was just telling your father about our mysterious raider, Admiral.
Oh, did you find out anything?
Found out the name of his broker. Peter Crossland of Crossland & Co. in Southampton. According to my source, he's acting on behalf of some high-powered accountant. Almost certainly a nominee.
We don't know exactly who.
No.
High-powered accountant. Acting for someone even more high-powered.
Any ideas?
I have a nasty suspicion.
Can you check it out?
Leave it with me.
Oh, morning, everyone.
Morning.
There we are, my love.
Thank you.
David, I don't think I'll stay for the meeting. I've got a very busy day ahead, and Avril has got my proxy. Bye-bye, love. Oh, I might pop in the yard this afternoon to see the lads.
I'll warn everyone. The shock might kill them.
bye-bye, David.
I'll be in touch.
Right.
Abby, may I come in? I want to talk to you. This isn't going to be easy. But I think you ought to know. Abby, I'm not your father. I wish I were.
Who is?
I think perhaps you'd better ask your mother that question.
Why are you telling me now?
Because it's just possible that your real father will try and get in touch with you, and I didn't want you to hear it from him. Sorry, it must be quite a shock.
Not really. I always thought of myself as a bit of a misfit. It wouldn't surprise me if my mother wasn't my real mother.
Try not to be bitter, Abby. She does love you, you know. I know it's difficult to believe sometimes, but she does. And we both do.
But we have different values. Well, now I see why.
You don't seem very surprised.
I'm not.
Does Gerald know about this visit?
Sort of.
Sort of. So what precisely does that mean? He sent you here as his ambassador.
It was my idea.
Ah.
You can humiliate me as much as you like, Charles. If you want me to beg, I'll beg. Please, Charles, take him back. For my sake.
Take him back? I really don't know what you mean, Polly. He's not an employee. He's a business associate. And he told me he no longer wished to be associated with me.
That's just semantics. You know perfectly well he depends on you for his livelihood. We both do.
Oh, he's changed his mind, has he? Or perhaps you changed it for him.
Does it matter?
It matters to me.
The point is, he realizes he's been very stupid, but it was just a temporary aberration.
You may tell Gerald that I'm prepared to resume our association, provided he wishes it. All he has to do is ask.
Thank you, Charles.
Don't worry. It'll all be sorted out.
That's what my dad used to say, but they still took the telly away.
Listen, Dawn, I'm selling some shares.
I just don't want to get involved, Jack. Debts and stuff. I had enough of all that when I was a kid.
That's my problem. It doesn't involve you. Listen, stick around, love. It's only a little squall. The boat's still seaworthy.
Yes, but for how long, Jack? How long until it runs into another little squall? Only next time, maybe it won't be so little.
There won't be a next time.
No, there won't be a next time. I'm sorry, Jack. We had a lot of fun together, but there's no future in it. For either of us.